Chuck Berry, 91 weeks in the UK charts.
Her home is on the south side, high up on a ridge.
Little Richard, 108 weeks.
Lucy, she comes back where you belong.
And Fats Domino, 109. Three giants have been playing rock and roll for 40 years apiece, but have never played on the same stage until tonight. In an hour's time, the Sheffield Arena will be the venue for the first of four historic concerts. Chuck was the first to arrive and told his first press conference in 20 years about the concerts.
They're very small, because this is a four-day tour, and three times we've done 90-day tour, one time a 92-day tour with the Irving Fell and the Biggest Show of Stars. So these are very small compared to my heyday tours. You know.
Chuck may have picked up his bus pass, but the act and the songs go on forever.
Yeah, the spirit's the same. The feeling is greater, and the duck walk is more correlated, shall we say.
Chuck's continued to tour regularly, but for Little Richard, it'll be his first Yorkshire date in 20 years. With a combined age of 194, they're not quite sure that it's their first date together.
I can't remember. I would think no. But I should say perhaps.
And who'll be headlining?
I don't know whichever way it's posted. It's okay with me at this stage of the game.
Fats Domino's also of pensionable age, but they're all dedicated to keeping alive the spirit of rock and roll.
I hope it'll never die. There's a title in one of my new songs that says, some people say that rock and roll would fade. It's been 40 years since that remark was made. I'm here to show that it's alive and well and all American, like ringing a bell.
This is Barry Hampshire from Scarborough. He wrote a book about Little Richard. He used to be the features editor of his local evening paper, but now he runs a hotel in the resort, where he's been known to serenade guests at breakfast. But tonight could be the greatest night of his life.
I'm hoping to play with Little Richard and his band. A lifetime ambition of mine to play with Little Richard. And he said about 2 weeks ago, when Chaz and I were talking to him, Chaz White, we were talking to him, and he said, bring your sax along and I'll ask you up on the stage. Now, this is something I've dreamed of. I've dreamed of this since I was a boy of 20 in 1957 when I first heard Richard. And I just hope it comes off.
With him at the Sheffield Arena, to see what's billed as the greatest rock show ever is Dr. Rock, with whom he wrote Little Richard's biography.
I think it's a wonderful idea. I mean, they used to do that with the jazzmen like Louis Armstrong and so on, and Ella Fitzgerald and so on. They're doing the same now, and it's just a wonderful idea. And it's, there's about 7,000 people here tonight, and just they're all bopping and hopping and enjoying themselves. It's wonderful stuff. Great idea. I'm all for it. The world is short of happiness. This is happiness.
Chuck Berry's raring to go.
We're in the movies.
Fat Domino's looking happy. But Little Richard's management don't seem too keen on the media. Fats Domino warms up the audience despite a bout of pneumonia. He was later taken to hospital for a checkup after cutting his set short.
Is everything all right? I mean, is it really all right?
It's certainly all right for these folk.
security. Help them up there. Sometimes I do.
One 6-year-old boy from Glasgow had the night of his life.
Set my watch and it was 12:45. I say, come on, y'all, and let's have a little fun. And we reel. Reeling, rocking, rolling, starting. Reeling, rocking, rolling till the break of dawn.
And the audience, well, they love it.
Is he all right?
Really good. I'm dying to get up and have a dance and, you know, I was out of my seat going.
It's alive and kicking.
Once they get going, that's it, you know, all hell's let loose.
If this is what getting old is like, I can't wait to be 90.
But now, for the big one.
What, bam,
62 years old, he's not exactly leaping onto the piano.
A long time ago, I could just jump all over the piano and jump all down the stage. My brothers used to have to beg me to come up. I've been up there 3 hours. And they said, Richard, you've been up there 3 hours. And you don't have to tell me that now, because I know when I've been up there a few minutes.
But he's doing okay tonight. That's not our Barry on sax. Has the man from Scarborough missed out? But no, the call finally comes.
Come on, Barry. Come on, Barry.
Hey, hey. And a lifetime ambition is realised.
Hey, hey. All right, come on, let's hop in. Let's go. Woo! Hey, all right.
Hey, hey. Absolutely wonderful. A dream come true for me. A 40-year dream come true. 1957. First heard Little Richard. Bought a saxophone. They didn't know what the heck it was. Bought a saxophone. Learned to play it with this day in mind. I'm 58 years old and I finally achieved my life ambition. Played on stage with Little Richard.